YouTube. Today I'm gonna make french fries. My kids like french fries a lot and I'm tired of going to the store and buying a whole bag, so I'm gonna make french fries. They're really quick and easy. Get your bag of potatoes and just cut them up. See, I cut them up in the sink. I peel them in the sink because I don't like to peel them over the trash can. It gets on my nerves. Then what I do, I take this bucket and I put some cold water in it. But as you can see, I put lemon juice in there because it keeps the potatoes bright so they don't turn brown. So when you fry them, they're still nice and bright. Oh, almost knocked the bucket in. We finished cutting up the potatoes. Somebody must be working on the water or something. Don't tell me nothing. You're gonna put some small fries. Falls off at the sink, but it's okay. It's the sink, you just rinse it off. Sink gotta be clean now. Make sure you clean the sink off. Nice and pink. Oh, wait a minute, that look kind of funny. Let me get that brown stuff off of there. If you got something brown, all you gotta do is just dig it out. Here you go. You don't want to turn your fire on yet. Just rinse it off. Real simple. Oh, that's a big one. I like that. Let's go on my new bag of potatoes. You can make french fries, potato chips, home fries, hash browns. You can make anything with a bag of potatoes if you know how to cook. So some of y'all don't know how to cook. I keep my potatoes in the refrigerator because it keeps them, so it won't blow into a plant. If you leave them out, it'll come back and be a whole plant. You're like, where'd that come from? That's what my mommy said. So my mommy said, you're right. I was always her kitchen helper, so I was always the one in the kitchen actually peeling the potatoes and cutting up this and that and the other. Got a lot of lumps.
It's lumpy.
Trash in the sink, so I clean up all my trash before I start cutting up the potatoes. I'm kind of a neat freak. Put everything in my strainer / colander. Depending on where you live at, what you call it. My mommy always called it a colander. My auntie and them, because they lived on 103rd and Dinker, they called it a strainer. Oh my gosh. Definitely messing with the pipe. I do now is I get my knife. I cut up about two potatoes. Then I turn my fire on. So I'm about to cut up my potatoes right now. Then I throw them back in the water. Cut them up like this. Then I cut them down like a nice little size. Can you see that? Maybe you need to come closer. Can you see the potatoes? No, you can't see the potatoes, huh? See? I'll sit you back over here. There you go. You can see him now? Can you see him now? Okay. I don't make them too thick or too thin. Just enough. But I don't want my potato to like roll on them. So I cut the bottom so it can stand up. When I do turn them over, you can cut them like that. I'll cut the bottom off so it'll stand up. See, so when you cut it, it won't roll on you. See, it didn't roll on me. Now I can lay them flat and cut them up. Nice size fries. When it gets on like this size, I turn it over because I don't want to cut my fingers. Just at my camera. This is so far over. Let me see if I can pan it down. Maybe you can see it. Yeah. Sit it back over there because it won't come off that way. I don't know what happened. No. I'll try it again. Turn the fire on the stove. I like my french fries thick. I like them nice in the middle. Alright. All done. I just rinsed off my cutting board. I'm gonna come back and clean everything off. Look, is all that ruckus. Now we're gonna fry fries. This is my cast iron skillet. As you can tell, it's blackened and seasoned very, very well. lots and lots of use. So, I'm going to let it get hot. I turned the fire up really high so it could get nice and hot. Then I turn it down just a little bit because I don't want the grease popping in my face and I don't want to do the hot popping grease dance. No, no. You know, although I am in desperate need of a pedicure, but we're all in need of a pedicure right now. I just don't want to have to go to the doctor with my toe up pedicure. No, no. So I'm just going to avoid that. Don't forget to put the lemon juice in your water to keep your potatoes nice and bright. Sit back and wait while I have my apple cider. Draining pan. I should be cleaning it, Lisa, but when I season up the fries, I like black pepper and pink Himalayan salt. This catches, it seasons the fries way better. Even the food, because it catches the food, doesn't like sit on top, it absorbs it. Tastes really, really good. Oh, it blow your socks off. Sounds like it's ready. Ooh, that was a song, huh? Seems like you're ready. I don't know who that was. I don't know. Oh, I can't remember. But it looked like that grease was ready. Out the big bowl and then I'll put it in this bowl and then I'm gonna throw it in the water. I mean in the grease. Until it's golden brown, like the tips are like kind of like brown, not black, like a nice golden brown. I don't really know the actual timing for it. I'll keep track, So that you'll know, but I usually don't do it because my mom never taught me that. She just said, stand over the stove and don't burn my food. So that's what I did. So I just know automatically when it's done, but I'll put a timer on it for you guys that don't know. So here we go. Right, we'll just sit back and we'll wait. I mix them together before I put them on. I don't do like one at a time. If you mix them together, you can get it all done in one easy swoop. You want to taste it. Oh, it's perfect. I like it a little salty, but not too salty to where I have to be on meds. But I'm not. Look at that. Nice French fries. They're gonna come out delicious. Also, delicious fries. Oh, my goodness. Yes. Any doctors want to give me a tummy tuck after quarantine, go right ahead. I will be your model. That's all I need. And then I'm gonna put them in a little red robin basket. for 10 minutes. Let's see. The fries are still light in color. So for me, it's not the way I want it to look. So I'm gonna do 5 more minutes.
Don't you grab it
though. Or maybe 5 more minutes
for you guys. For you guys.
So we're gonna put it in for 15 minutes. Now some of the smaller ones are done. You can take those right on out. That one's done. A little tiny one here, want to get a little cooked or something like that. It's this gross when you want to bite into a fry and the outside is hot, the inside is cold and crunchy. No. It does not work for me. They put it in for about 12 minutes. See that? About 12 minutes, it came out perfect. Now, put your little salt and stuff on it. You want to put it on when it's hot. Mix it up. Put it on when it's cold because the season is not going to stick and it's not going to sink through the potato. Let me see. Ooh, ice. Hot. Very well. Perfect homemade french fries. Ooh, hot. You don't have to ever buy french fries in a bag anymore. Let's go get you a bag of potatoes. Fresh fries. Ooh, I forgot to turn the timer on. All right. Here you go. Thanks for watching my YouTube channel. Go ahead and subscribe. Bye.